Virtually everyone's got a beloved Disney classic or two in their childhood memories. But just because the studio is incredibly good at making movies, doesn't mean that they are flawless. Pretty much every Disney film is hiding at least one plot hole. Maybe as a child you didn't notice them, but Disney-loving adults have searched them out. Don't worry, though, plot holes don't destroy the Disney magic, they just make you think. 20. Rapunzel's hair doesn't actually reach the ground, Tangled. Everyone knows how Rapunzel gets down from her tower, she lowers her hair. But a clever Tumblr user, the nameless doll, pointed out something in 2015. Rapunzel makes a pulley system with her hair to escape the tower, but it shouldn't work. After all, the Tangled writers once stated that Rapunzel's hair is 70 feet long. Therefore, Rapunzel would need double the amount of the hair that she has, which would mean 140 feet of hair. The nameless doll wrote. And that's clearly not the case. 19. Why doesn't Woody remember his previous owners? Toy Story 2. The big revelation in Toy Story 2 is that Woody is a toy who's at least 40 years old, as he was created for Woody's Roundup, a 1950s and Universe Kids series. And Andy's mother also mentions at one point that he's an old family toy. In that case, you'd think Woody would remember the other family members that he's been passed around, especially if one of them was Andy's dad. Yet they never come up. 18. Why doesn't Ariel write Eric a note? The Little Mermaid. We all know the deal that Ariel struck with the sea witch Ursula, legs in exchange for her beautiful voice. This stops Ariel from being able to properly communicate with her beloved Prince Eric. But why couldn't she have written him a note explaining the situation? Well, the Huffington Post questioned Tom Cito, an animator on the movie, about it in 2015 and he replied that whenever they've been asked that particular puzzler by children, the animators just grin and move on. 17. Why does the Cars world have buildings? Cars. Cars presents audiences with a world of, well, cars. So why are there buildings? Not only do cars not need buildings but who built them in the first place? Many a fan theory has been proposed about this very issue, including the idea that maybe the human race has been entirely wiped out and replaced with the automobiles that they created. Meep. 16. What are the seven dwarfs doing with their treasure? Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Every day it seems that the seven dwarfs go to work in mines, singing the cheerful hi-ho song as they dig. From their mines they collect diamonds and jewels. That fits in with the lore surrounding dwarfs, but what are the friends of Snow White doing with all that booty? They live in a tiny home with no riches to be seen whatsoever. 15. Why didn't Cinderella's glass slipper disappear? Cinderella. Cinderella's fairy godmother gives her everything that she needs to look like a princess, including a pair of glass slippers. But it all disappears after midnight. Except for the shoes. Of course, if they had disappeared there would be no happy ending, but what gives? And that's not even getting into how desperately agonizing wearing glass slippers would be in the first place. 14. How did Belle get the Beast onto her horse? Beauty and the Beast. After the Beast saves Belle from a pack of wolves, he lies there bleeding and unconscious in the snow. But then the scene cuts to the Beast on the back of Belle's horse. How on earth did she get him up there? How many muscles is she hiding under that dress? Luckily, the 2017 live-action remake dealt with this problem. In that movie, the Beast manages to get himself up off of the ground, no hidden muscles necessary. 13. Why doesn't Charlotte give Tiana money for her restaurant? The Princess and the Frog. Even though The Princess and the Frog takes place in segregated 1920s America, Charlotte seems to be genuine friends with Tiana. So that makes it all the more strange that she never offers the young waitress a share of her obvious wealth to buy the restaurant that she dreams of. Of course, you can argue that Tiana would never have taken it. But she could have offered. 12. Why doesn't Hades know that Hercules is dead? Hercules. Hades wants Hercules dead, so he sends his henchmen, Pain and Panic, to take care of the job. They fail completely and then just lie about it. Hades definitely isn't the only Disney villain to have incompetent minions mess up a plan, but he is the lord of the underworld. Shouldn't he have checked to see if Hercules' soul was around somewhere? You can't put the blame entirely on Pain and Panic for that one. 11. Why does Ariel eat seafood? The Little Mermaid. While off gallivanting with her prince, Ariel can be seen indulging in human delights and, at one point, she eats some seafood. Except, Ariel, in a sense, recently was at least 50% seafood. And she counts a fish and a crab among her closest friends. And all the ocean creatures that she's ever met are sentient. Ariel, how could you? 10. Why can't Olaf break the curse? Frozen. To save Anna from Elsa's accidental curse, someone must perform for her an act of true love. Her kiss from a prince goes awry, but someone else provides that act, Olaf the snowman, who starts a fire for Anna, despite knowing it'll melt him. So why didn't that fix everything? Well, animator Mark Han did explain it, a little, in 2013, telling CBN that Olaf possessed childlike love, which apparently wasn't what Anna needed. 9. Why isn't Aladdin really a prince? Aladdin. Aladdin wishes for the genie to make him a prince, and that certainly seems to come true. He gains the riches and title of a prince. But seemingly, is not actually a royal. He assumes that Jasmine still can't marry him, and he clearly hasn't been retroactively made princely by birth. Was the genie having a major off day? Or is instant princehood impossible even for him? 8. Why does Zazu never question what happened to Mufasa? The Lion King. Zazu, Mufasa's loyal right-hand bird, panics when he sees Mufasa and Simba about to get trampled by wildebeest. When he tries to go back for help, the wicked Scar flings him into a wall and knocks him out. This might have left Zazu with a touch of memory loss, but surely he should have asked a few more questions about what exactly happened on the day that Mufasa, and, he assumes, Simba, died. Still, he is a bird brain. 8. Why does Zazu never question what happened to Mufasa? The Lion King. Zazu, Mufasa's loyal right-hand bird, panics when he sees Mufasa and Simba about to get trampled by wildebeest. When he tries to go back for help, the wicked Scar flings him into a wall and knocks him out. This might have left Zazu with a touch of memory loss, but surely he should have asked a few more questions about what exactly happened on the day that Mufasa, and, he assumes, Simba, died. Still, he is a bird brain. 6. Why don't the villagers know or care about the nearby castle? Beauty and the Beast. How come neither Belle nor her fellow French villagers seem to remember that there was once a prince in the castle right next to them? Or ever question what became of him or his servants? This bugged fans of the original Beauty and the Beast so much that Disney fixed the problem for the 2017 version. There, the enchantress who cursed the beast also curses the surrounding village so that they forget that the castle and its inhabitants ever existed. 5. How can two people hope to look after 101 dogs? 101 Dalmatians. Yes, Dalmatians are very cute, and Roger and Anita do have the money to buy a bigger house at the end of the movie. But still, owning over 100 dogs is an almost impossible task no matter where you live. What happens when the puppies grow up and have puppies of their own? What happens when Roger and Anita want children? Disney did not think that one through. 4. How does Elsa actually live in her ice castle? Frozen. In one of Frozen's most show-stopping scenes, Elsa creates herself an ice castle. But fans both young and old have questioned, what does she do for food? How she takes care of bathroom business is another matter entirely, Adina Menzel, otherwise known as the voice of Elsa, ended up answering the question, albeit jokingly, in a 2014 Facebook Q&A. She eats soy ice cream sandwiches. 3. Why doesn't Charlotte turn into a frog when she kisses Naveen? The Princess and the Frog. In order to break the frog curse on Tiana and Naveen, Tiana's friend Charlotte tries kissing Naveen herself. But surely she should have been turned into a frog as well? That's what happens when a non-princess kisses a frog, and Charlotte wasn't a princess at that point. Fans have suggested numerous theories. Is it because Charlotte's motives were selfless? Or was it because she was the second woman to be kissed? No one knows. 2. Why does Buzz Lightyear freeze around humans? Toy Story. Much of the Toy Story plot revolves around toys turning back into, well, toys whenever humans are around. But Buzz Lightyear believes he's a real spaceman, not a toy, so why does he also freeze? Craig Good, who worked on the movie, answered this question on the website Quora in 2015. It didn't really need to be acknowledged. Part of the fun for an audience, especially in the first act, is figuring out the rules of the world, he said. So there. 1. Why doesn't the Beast's timeline make sense? Beauty and the Beast. If you really pay attention to Beauty and the Beast, it becomes clear that the timeline just doesn't add up. The curse becomes permanent on the Beast's 21st birthday and the castle's been cursed for 10 years. So the Beast was 11 when he became a Beast? Except that the portrait of the human Beast clearly shows an adult. Luckily, the remake released in 2017 sorted all of this out, making it clear that the Beast was a grown man.